Something wrong, Twilight? Don't be so upset, Twilight. You have me. What would you need as a friend like me?
That's odd. Where did all this come from? I can't see a thing. Oh! Ow! Oh, my nose. Hello? Is somebody there?
Signal box. Percy's driver explained what had happened. "I'll see to it," said the signalman, "but you better clean Percy or people will think he's a ghost." Percy chuckled. "Do let's pretend I'm a ghost and scare Thomas. That'll teach him to say I'm a silly little engine." Toby promised to help.
I'm sure some twilight. It's probably just the wind. And like Elsa said, there's a ghost, right?
But there's something worse. Out with it, Toby. I can't wait all evening. I've just seen something, said Toby. It looked like Percy's ghost. It said it was coming here to warn us. Puh, who cares? Don't be frightened, Toby. I'll take care of you.
Safe. At last. There's no way that ghost is gonna get to us in my room.
Wait! Huh? What is it? Actually... Could you stay with me? Just at least until my dad comes back? Sure, Bambi.
Thanks, Twilight.
Good night.
Though Bambi was relieved to have some company, he could barely figure out or admit to anyone what he'd just stumbled upon. He wondered if it was the mist playing tricks on him, or that it was all in his imagination. But try as he possibly might, he couldn't deny that he went face to face with a real spectre on the rails.
It's getting late. Oh, I'd no idea. Oh, I must find Annie and Clarabelle.